everyone, and welcome back to my channel, or if you're new here, hi, my name is Nicole and I'm a part-time reseller on Poshmark, and today I want to talk about some features and things that maybe you didn't know what they were on Poshmark or what they mean or how to do them. There's a couple things that I constantly see people asking, what is this or how to do that? And so I just wanted to cover that in today's video. So this is kind of like a catch-all, secret features, but also what does that mean on Poshmark? So if that is something that is interesting to you, I hope you stick around and I hope you subscribe for more reselling content. But without further ado, let's get right into the video. Okay, so the first thing I want to talk about is the reserved banner that will show up on your listings randomly. So this means that the item is reserved, quote unquote, for the time being because somebody has hit that buy now button, meaning that they are in the checkout process. This does not mean that the item is going to sell because somebody could always back out of the checkout process, but they reserve it while the person is checking out because it's not really fair if somebody else buys it while they're already in the process of checking out. So that's what that little yellow icon is. It's like a banner that says reserved on your listings. And like I said, this appears only when somebody is in checkout. And so you may see it for a few minutes on your page, you may see it go away quickly, you may see that it results in a sale immediately, but a lot of people always ask what that means or why they see reserved on their icon. Simply, it just means that the person is buying it and they are in the checkout process and they are filling out their credit card or their shipping information, so it shows up right away to protect that person while they are trying to purchase. And so like I said, it does not mean that they are necessarily going to buy or not, but it really does most of the time lead to sales for me, but I have seen a couple times where it was reserved and the person didn't end up buying it. Now, when you see a reserved item, you can still share it and you can still, you know, edit it and stuff like that. But if it does turn to sold, then you are not going to be able to edit it after that. Okay, so the next thing is when you see an item that says not for sale. So this can mean many different things. I've seen so many different uses for not for sale. So a lot of the times I make like advertisements at the top of my closet, or I have a listing that promotes my live sales that I do. So I have that one marked as not for sale as well. So in many cases, it really just means that either the person is away on vacation and so therefore all of their items are marked not for sale, or if they have specific items that are marked for sale, they could have one sold on another platform, or two, they could just not want to sell that current item at that moment. They might need to, you know, do some changes to the listing or whatever the case may be. Or maybe three, they just can't find the item and so they marked it as not for sale. So there are many different reasons for the not for sale thing, and all this really means is that you just can't buy that listing. You can still like it, you can still be, you know, notified if a buyer has a live sale by liking the listing, but you can't buy anything that says not for sale. But if you like it, if it's something that you think will become available soon, like say the person's on vacation, you can like it, and then that way when they're back, you remember to buy it. But simply, all it means is that you can't currently buy that item. You may be able to or you may not. You just definitely want to check with the seller to make sure that the item is still actually available when they return from, if they're on a break or something like that. Okay, so the next feature that I want to talk about is Poshmark Stories. So this is kind of like a hidden feature that I feel like they released a while ago, but they didn't really talk about it much. It really wasn't that big. And it actually has a lot of benefits. So what it is basically a story that goes to your profile, like a social media, and basically it's all of the listings that have videos in it, and it just kind of plays all of those videos in like a story form. And it lasts more than 24 hours. I've seen that it lasts like several days, maybe even several weeks. I don't even really know, to be honest, how long it lasts, but it definitely lasts more than say a social media story would. But it kind of works the same way. So when you make a listing and it has a video, they automatically get filtered into that Posh Stories and it'll show up on your account and you'll see a little red circle around your icon. And that just basically means that you do have a current story. Now you can click on that and watch it and see, and you could also go to see other people's stories as well. Now this is a nice feature because again, it shows up in people's feeds as like a story and it will show up for more than just that day. So if someone is scrolling through the app and you had added something to your closet several days ago and they just saw that story, they may want to go get it now. And so it kind of may lead to some sales. And it just gets a better kind of like eye on those items. And I find that adding videos to some items is very helpful because sometimes it's hard to show textures or show material or show like that it's see-through or not. And so I use those stories in examples like that. And I think stories can be very beneficial, but again, not a lot of people really know about them. Okay, so the next feature is the drops soon feature. So this is basically exactly what you think it is. This just means that the item is not currently available, and a lot of the times it will have a, you know, dropping date, and this is just basically to build some hype around an item. So all this is a listing that is created that is not currently available for purchase, but if you like the item, when it actually drops, you will get notified, and so therefore you can buy it right away. And so some people like to do this if they have like a really good new addition to their closet and they really want to build some hype, they will do this. And so like I said, if you like the item, then you will be notified when it actually goes live and you will be one of the first people to see that it is live so you can purchase it. Okay, and the final thing I wanted to talk about in this video is how to follow other accounts on Poshmark. So a lot of people always ask me how to follow other accounts because it's not very obvious and people get confused because when you type into the search bar, it's more searching for specific items on Poshmark. So there's a specific way that you need to go to find people on Poshmark. So if you're on your homepage in the newsfeed, and I will insert a video to kind of show you what this, the demo of this, but if you're on your homepage, you'll see a little people icon in the top right corner next to the search bar. If you click on that, that's going to bring you to your people feed. So that's going to bring you to like adding your contacts, syncing your Facebook, finding other poshers and stuff like that. So if you click on that, you will see that the search bar in the top says find people. So when you type into that search bar, it will actually search accounts. So you have to search by the handle and you have to know the specific handle for the person to come up. But if you try and search for a handle in the prior page, which is just the overall search, it's not, the person's name is not going to come up because that is the search for, you know, listings on Poshmark. So this is kind of hidden. I know a lot of people don't know how to actually go and follow people or find accounts. So I definitely wanted to add this in this video because again, it's kind of hidden and it's a secret feature that a lot of people don't really know about and don't really know that it exists or how to get there. And so I just figured this could help somebody because at first I didn't really know how to find someone's listing. And so somebody would give me their handle and I'd go check out their closet and I literally wouldn't know how to do that. So this was really helpful for me when I learned it. And I'm sure it's helpful for a lot of people that don't already know how to find other accounts on Poshmark. So that is a wrap on, again, these random five features that I definitely wanted to talk about in this video that were things that you may not know how to do, or you may not have known that they existed or what they were. So if this was helpful for you, make sure you give this video a like. I love doing these like feature videos because there are so many features of Poshmark that so many people don't know about. And I just want to bring some light to those features because there are so many features that are really helpful to actually know how to use and utilize properly. And if you don't know about them, then you're not gonna be able to use them. So if you want to see other secret features on Poshmark, then you can click right here. And if you want to see some tips on how to get daily consistent sales, you can click right here. But until next time, I will see you then.